afternoon, everyone. I'm Elise Kylie, editor of the Spirits Business magazine, and welcome to the Spirits Business Awards 2020. As I'm sure you will appreciate, due to reasons beyond our control, it sadly wasn't possible to host our annual awards ceremony in person this year. However, I assure you we are just as excited to celebrate this year's worthy winners with you virtually today. In a year that has presented immeasurable challenges for the spirits trade, we believe it is all the more important to shine a light on the truly excellent work that goes on across the industry. It is precisely this level of creativity, business acumen, adaptability, and global community spirit that leaves us with no doubt that there is a prosperous future ahead for the spirits trade. Before we begin, I would like to thank our esteemed panel of judges who took the time to carefully deliberate and discuss this year's entries over Skype. Namely, David T. Smith, spirits writer and co-founder of the Craft Distilling Expo, Brian Rodriguez, wine and spirits buyer for Harvey Nichols, Sophia Terzopoulou, head of marketing at 3 Cents Artisanal Beverages, and Heather Fritchie, CEO of the Spearhead Group, which sponsored the Innovation in Packaging Award. A huge thank you also goes to this year's official sponsor of the Spirits Business Awards, 3 Cents Artisanal Beverages. And thanks also to Glencairn Crystal for supplying the trophies. Like last year's awards, in addition to the winner from each category, the judges also awarded runner-up and special commendation awards in certain areas. In terms of the running order of today's awards, I'll begin with the retail and marketing winners and finish with the People Awards, culminating in the Lifetime Achievement Award for a remarkable member of the trade. So please do stay tuned until the end. Now, without further ado, let's begin. First up, the Spirits Retailer of the Year Award. In a keenly contested category, the judges agreed the runner-up award should go to the Whiskey Exchange. As for the winner, this company was chosen for creating a point of difference in the retail sphere. And so the Spirits Retailer of the Year Award goes to 31 Dover. Next, we have an award for Spirits Bottler of the Year. Praised for its brilliant marketing, innovation and accessibility, the 2020 winner is Douglas Lang & Company. Moving on to the Distributor of the Year Award, and due to its focus on education, experiential platforms and personalised service, the runner-up award goes to Spirit Cartel. The winner is a firm that demonstrated a true sense of pride and care for their staff, customers and the brands they work with. Therefore, the Distributor of the Year 2020 is Demonic. In an industry as fast-paced as the spirits trade, clever, captivating marketing campaigns are crucial to attract new audiences. The runner-up award in the Best New Marketing Campaign category goes to an initiative that succeeded in bringing together thousands of whiskey fans in the midst of the pandemic with home blending kits, which enabled them to virtually create a new whiskey expression together. That campaign was Flavia and Whistlepig Blended at Home. But the winner in this category is a brand that shunned the traditional use of celebrity endorsements in favour of a thorough, wide-reaching campaign that encompassed everything from music and social media to comedy and gaming. And so the winner of the Best New Marketing Campaign is Chase the Next by Indian whiskey brand Sterling Reserve. Now, although events have looked a little different this year, there has certainly been no shortage in effective, engaging experiences taking place worldwide. In our best event category, a special commendation goes to Risk Takers, Rule Breakers and Cocktail Shakers by Freehand Beverages, which celebrated women in the industry in India. The runner-up award goes to another Indian event which worked to bring spirits brands and the hospitality sector closer together and give bartenders the chance to showcase their skills through a nationwide cocktail competition. The runner-up for best event is Greater Than Bar Wars by Now Spirits and Beverages. But taking the winning title of Best Event 2020 is a marathon online event that brought rum novices and aficionados together from across the globe to celebrate the 50th anniversary of Black Tot Day. The winner is Black Tot Day 24-hour Festival of Rum. Having the right PR team to communicate your brand message in a clear, candid, and engaging manner is incredibly important to attract that all-important media attention. With a number of high-quality, classic brands under its portfolio and first-class ability to build meaningful media relationships, the PR Company of the Year 2020 is Mayfox Communications. Our next set of awards fall under the Sustainability and Innovation umbrella. To present our Distillery Sustainability Award, I'd like to hand over to one of this year's judges, David T. Smith.
The environmental side of distilling has been important for a long time, but is becoming increasingly important day by day. And so in our distillery sustainability category, we had a great selection of entrants, and we are giving a special commendation to Cape Byron Distillery from Australia. They've achieved some great milestones, and that includes planting 35,000 rainforest trees. Next, the runner-up award. It's a company that does charitable sponsorship, looks into wastewater reduction, and uses 100% wind power at the distillery. But most impressively, recently they have totally revamped their packaging range so it's sustainably focused, something that we all can learn from. It's Ian McLeod Distillers. And finally, the distillery that gets the top position is one that has embraced green and environmental credentials from day one. They use 100% green energy. They have a gin refill scheme, and they look at trying to reduce food miles by using local raw materials. And they even donate 1% of gross gin sales to a partner tree planting charity. The winner is, of course, the English producer, Cooper King Distillery. Well done.
Now, let's take a look at the Ethical Award. After much deliberation, the judges wanted to give a special commendation to Flor de Canya Rum for its progress to being a more ethical company. But the winner of this award goes to a distributor that stepped up to support distilleries that were affected by the Australian wildfires earlier this year. I'm delighted to present the 2020 Ethical Award to the hugely deserving Nip and Courage. Moving on to the Innovation in Production category, and there was a standout winner. The judges were impressed by this distillery's quick thinking that not only ensured tainted grapes from the 2019 and 2020 Australian bushfires did not go to waste, but guaranteed local growers were supported. The winner of the Innovation in Production Award is Archie Rose Distilling Company for its Hunter Valley Shiraz Spirit. Our next award is Innovation in Packaging, and to present this year's winners, I will hand over to Heather Fritchie, co-founder and CEO of the Spearhead Group, which is sponsoring the award.
My fellow judges and I would like to thank the dozens of brands and companies who entered into the Innovation in Packaging Awards this year. There were so many entries, we actually had a hard time narrowing it down to our special commendation runner-up in first place, so we added a second special commendation. The first special commendation goes to Lefay Superior Absinthe 200ml for a unique format that makes absinthe more accessible and more approachable to the home consumer. The second special commendation goes to Mirabeau Gin for its innovative bottle shape and its light and airy feel. The runner-up goes to Casa Lagartos Rum for its lizard skin bottle texture that imparts so much presence without using extra packaging material. And the winner of the Innovation in Packaging Award for 2020 goes to Bullard's Gin for their bottles that are too good to throw away and their eco-friendly, mailbox-friendly pouch refill system. Congratulations to all the winners.
Moving on to the Tourism Awards, and to begin with, we have the Distillery Consumer Experience Award, in which a special commendation goes to Bardenay's De Paz Distillery in Martinique. The judges also awarded a runner-up award to Irish whiskey distillery Roe & Co. But the winner of the Distillery Consumer Experience Award goes to an English site that the judges agreed is a must-visit distillery, with its Grade 2 listed archways, gin tours and tastings, and even a hands-on gin-making experience. The winner is Manchester Gin. Our next award recognises outstanding contribution to spirits tourism. As the most visited distillery in Scotland, and with a staggering 117% increase in visitor numbers from 2010 to 2019, the winner is Glengoyne. One of the most highly coveted awards has to be Best New Product, and this year saw a record number of recent releases entered into this category. Due to the exceptionally high caliber of entrants, the judges were excited to offer two special commendations. The first special commendation goes to Amaretto, Adriatico and Blanco for bringing a fun and modern approach to Amaretto. The judges also gave a special commendation to Colombian rum La Hechicera Seri Experimental No. 2 for its colourful and tropical vibes. Coming in a close second and receiving the runner-up award for Best New Product due to its all-encompassing range of products is non-alcoholic brand Liars. But the Best New Product of 2020, with its attention to detail and beautiful premium aesthetic, is Tom Savano Cocktails. In the final section of our awards, we celebrate the people behind the brands we know and love. First of all, the Blender of the Year Award. This award goes to someone who is a true expert in her field and has honed her craft working across numerous high-profile brands. The Blender of the Year 2020 is Kirsty McCullum, Head of Whisky Creation at Glenmurray.
Hi, I'm over the moon to be awarded Blender of the Year by the Spirits Business. I'm so privileged to work in this industry, to work with something I love so much and I'm so passionate about, and to work with so many great people. And I just wanted to say how much this award means to me. Thank you so much.
For the Distiller of the Year Award, the judges agreed to award a special commendation to Demira Ukalieva of AYU. The runner-up award goes to a distiller whose dedication to the heritage of Barbados rum is evident for all to see. The runner-up is Master Distiller Don Ben from the West Indies Rum Distillery. However, the winner is a distiller who has put an innovative stamp on traditional products, resulting in multiple high-quality, award-winning spirits. The 2020 Distiller of the Year is Dave Withers from Archie Rose Distilling Company.
Hi folks, I'm Dave Withers from Archie Rose Distilling. Just wanted to say thank you, such an amazing accolade. Really appreciate it given the growth of the spirits industry worldwide that you would honour me in this way. Thanks so much folks.
To present the penultimate award of the day, I'd like to once again hand over to David T. Smith.
Our Young Achiever of the Year award goes to someone who has accomplished an awful lot in a very short amount of time. From founding a distillery at 25 years old to being instrumental into building Australia's distilling reputation worldwide. It puts a lot of the rest of us to shame, for sure. And if you haven't guessed who it is already, and they make fantastic spirits, it is Will Edwards, the founder of Archie Rose Distilling Company in Australia. Cheers, Will.
Hi, everyone. I'm Will Edwards. I'm the founder of Archie Rose. And I just wanted to say a huge thank you for the award. 2020 has obviously been a really challenging year. And at the same time, we've been commissioning our brand new distillery. So, yeah, to receive this sort of recognition is pretty amazing. So thank you very much.
And now on to our final and most prestigious award of the day, the Lifetime Achievement Award. The recipient of this award is an industry stalwart with whiskey in his blood, a second-generation bottler and soon-to-be producer whose sharp, passionate, knowledgeable and quick-witted qualities make him an inspirational figure throughout the industry. I am delighted to announce that the Lifetime Achievement Award goes to Fred Lang from Douglas Lang & Company.
Well, firstly, to the spirits business, for me, the best liquor magazine around, I want to say thank you so very much for this Lifetime Achievement Award. I'm certainly surprised and I'm elated even to be considered for it. Thank you. This award caps what has been an amazingly good year in very difficult trading conditions for our company here at Douglas Lang. The remarkable regional malts led by Big Pete from Isla and by Scallywag from the Speyside region, allied to our King of Scots blended Scotch whisky, go from strength to strength. We now own the Bijou and Craft Strathairn Distillery in the Highlands, our Glasgow-based Clutha Distillery, which is being built continues apace. So, all in, your award is the icing on the cake. You've made an old man, or at least an oldish man, very happy. And I thank you once again.
Congratulations to all of our winners today. You'll be able to find a more detailed write-up of this year's judging process and all of the 2020 winners in the December 2020 edition of the Spirits Business magazine and on our website at thespiritsbusiness.com. But for now, I'd like to thank you all for tuning into the awards today. And once again, thank you to our innovation and packaging sponsor, the Spearhead Group, and the official sponsor of the Spirits Business Awards 2020, 3 Cents Artisanal Beverages. On behalf of the Spirits Business team, we would like to wish you all the very best in the coming year. And we look forward to celebrating the Spirits Business Awards with you all in person again in 2021.